Ankylosing spondylitis affects approximately 3.2 million adults in the United States. We recently discussed about how to diagnose ankylosing spondylitis, or AS, and today we're going to discuss about, can AS be treated? What are the current treatments for AS? Is AS reversible or it can be curable? What happens if you don't treat AS? And how important is exercise in the treatment of AS? This video is for educational purpose only and will not substitute medical evaluation by a physician. For any medical advice, please contact your physician. Ankylosing spondylitis is a type of inflammatory arthritis that can affect the spine, the peripheral joints, but also other organs like your heart, your lungs, your eyes, and sometimes your kidneys. Unfortunately, many patients get diagnosed late after many years of symptoms. I had a separate video about how to diagnose AS. After diagnosis, many patients ask me, can AS be treated? And my answer is yes. In our days, AS has great treatment options. In the past, the only therapy available were the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications. Today, we start the therapy with non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication, or as we call them, NSAIDs. About 70 to 80% of patients have great relief in their pain and stiffness with anti-inflammatory medication. A few examples of NSAIDs are naproxen, diclofenac, meloxicam, or colecoxib. There is no evidence that one NSAID is better than another one in treatment. However, when researchers look at the safety profile of these drugs, diclofenac was associated with increased risk of heart attacks while naproxen was not. What are the current treatments for AS? Besides the treatment with NSAIDs, we do have access today to newer treatments. We call these biologic medications. Biologic medications are more advanced and targeted medication that will block proteins involved in the process of inflammation. These molecules are tumor necrosis alpha, or as we call it, TNF-alpha, and interleukin-17, or IL-17. Researchers show that patients with AS have increased level of TNF-alpha and IL-17 in their bodies, and these molecules were responsible for creating and maintaining inflammation. Based on these findings, newer classes of medication to target these molecules have evolved. These are called biologics. Biologics will block these molecules, and the consequence will be a decreased level of inflammation. Most commonly used TNF-alpha inhibitors are adalimumab, etanercept, infliximab, golimumab, and certolizumab. IL-17 inhibitors are a newer class of medication that we use in patients with AS. If the patients do not respond to TNF-alpha inhibitors, or if they have a contraindication to this medication, then IL-17 inhibitors are next in line. The most commonly used are secukinumab and ixekizumab. When it comes to choose a specific treatment, please discuss with your physician that can carefully evaluate your specific medical situation and will prescribe you the appropriate treatment. Once again, this video is for educational purpose and will not offer you medical advice. Is AS reversible or can it be curable? Unfortunately, AS is a chronic inflammatory arthritis that is not curable with medication. The role of the medication is to stop the progression of the disease and prevent further damage of your joints or of the spine. patients that are treated have a lower likelihood to develop severe ankylosing of the spine or get disabled. As physicians, we know that there are certain factors that are associated with a poor outcome, such as being a smoker or having a high activity disease, or being a male or having an HLA-B27, or if you have a history of inflammation in the eyes, or a history of psoriasis, and even a history of an inflammatory bowel disease. What happens if you don't treat AS? Unfortunately, many patients with untreated disease will develop many complications, from ankylosing of the spine to inability to turn the head, severe hip arthritis, or the humpback. The quality of life is severely impacted by the lack of mobility or chronic pain. Patients with untreated AS have an increased risk to develop osteoporosis. And fractures, and also spinal cord injury. This chronic persistent inflammation is not only present in the joints, but can also affect other organs, such as the heart or the kidneys. Patients with untreated AS have also an increased cardiovascular risk, and they will be at increased risk for heart attacks or strokes, and even diseases of the aortic root, and also venous blood clots. How important is exercise in the treatment of AS? Exercise is and should remain an essential part of treatment in patients with AS. Exercises should include range of motion, stretching, or aquatic therapy. In my practice, I encourage patients to find a physical therapist that will work with them on a regular basis. To help patients, I have also created an online course that will include a complete guide for nutrition, stress management, exercises, and also sleep management for patients with inflammatory arthritis like AS. I will list the link in the description of this video. However, spinal manipulation should be avoided in patients with spinal fusion or advanced spinal osteoporosis. I hope this video answers many questions for you. If you are concerned about ankylosing spondylitis or what is the best treatment for you if you have ankylosing spondylitis, please consult a rheumatologist that will be able to help you. If you like the content of this educational video, don't forget to like, share, or subscribe to my channel. Thank you.
Rheumatologistoncall.com